To say this place is a mess is an understatement. Johnny's got half-built cars tucked away in every crevice. There's no room to move around, and the lift and equipment look like they haven't been touched in ages. Not using that lift alone is about $1,000 a day down the drain. It doesn't look like you have much tools. What's going on over here? Is this the only tools you have?
Well, yeah, nuts and the bolts here. Some of the tools that I let the guys use, that little box over there.
So how's that door roll down with it being all bashed up like that in the corners?
Okay, honestly, the door doesn't work. It hasn't worked for 7 years.
You don't shut the door?
Nope.
What do you do for security?
Well, I put up the chain right there and a sign that says, keep out. Good Lord's been taking care of this place.
They had toolboxes that didn't have tools in them. They have cars undercover, parts that are not labeled, surfboards. It's just chaos.
What's the Armageddon thing here?
Okay, that's my secret life.
Okay.
The Armageddon is a design that I patented. It's a full American supercar that's underway of being built. That's my dream, and I'm working on it.
I'm starting to see what kind of guy Johnny is. He's a little scattered and a dreamer because he's got dreams of building this big car one day and what have you. I get it. Without dreams, I wouldn't have Gas Monkey Garage or my tequila business or my bar and grill. He seems all over the place, but he hasn't lost me yet.
You know, it's early in the morning. I got to get a jump on this garage. The guys from Got Junk are going to pull in this morning. We're going to start to the wall, get the out. I need everything. Hello, let's go. I need everything that's garbage is going to end up going in the truck. You see, it's already here. It beat you guys here.
Getting up at 6 a.m. is a pain in the...
All right, come on, let's go.
We got a lot of cool vintage pieces out here, so we need to separate those from the junk.
Keep it slow on the bump.
We're the good old boys.
Yeah, baby, surfing cars.
I'm going for a ride.
I really like Johnny, but I got to keep him in line if we're going to turn this garage around. Stop standing on the hood like an idiot.
Okay, coming down.
He gets a 9 all across from the judges.
I need to get all these out of here.
You know, Russell's an interesting character. I love the guy.
This is what you should put on this business.
Heard he was kind of a nightmare in the shop with his punctuality, his critiquing, his criticisms.
Oh, right, because you need all these glasses. Hey, no, that's cool. We should... I don't know where my glasses keep going. Casey, have you seen my glasses?
You know what? We pretty much followed his lead, and we were responsive, and he really took a liking to us. He's kind of a pain sometimes, but I love the guy. He was all right. We ended up being friends.
All right. Cool, man.
Good times.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. Get to work! I'm thinking we go with a wall straight from that door, straight to this door here. It's kind of hard to sign checks on a steering wheel. So at this end of the shop, 2 new rooms that didn't exist before will give Johnny a place to do business and meet with clients about their hot rods.
I'd love to have 3 lifts because you technically have 3 technicians and 1 owner manager. To take advantage of this 4,200 square foot space, we're gonna drop in 2 10,000 pound lifts here and a 9,000 pound lift here. It'll cost about 10 grand, but bring in about $800 a day per lift.
So this is the bay door. This was the only way that they came in, and they said this thing hasn't closed in 7 years. And now you know why. So we will remove the old broken garage door and replace it with a new functioning door for a better workflow. We will create another garage door on the other side. We make a double door here. They swing out, keeps the old Barney feel, hot rod. This way we can bring cars in 2 sides of the building. Easier access means more cars and more money are rolling into this shop.
All right, fine. You guys handle it. I may or may not go back to Dallas, or I might just go to the beach.
So Richard's given me $150,000 and a week to turn this place into a hot rod super shop. But this is an old building. Only time will tell how long that'll last. See ya! Now you can add a extinguisher refill to your bill.
It's $50, man.
So it's not budget.
I think it's just crap. That's what the track's supposed to. What I'll probably do is once we have this out and I'm gonna knock this, I'm gonna get inside and probably just lift it with the forklift.
To break it free.
We don't really need this as
a track.
Once we have it there, we're good. It's lifting the back of the forklift off the ground.
These doors are 70, 80 years old, so it's really important we don't break it because it's irreplaceable and will just take more time to fix.
So if you look down here, you can see that there's actually a metal track that this angle iron guides with to keep the door from kind of flapping back and forth with a breeze or storm. But it's rusted completely solid. Now we're trying to get it to slide, almost like a closet door. Wishful thinking, but pretty sure we can get it done.
There we go. So this one, we had an issue with the fact that it had not moved in who knows how long, so the bottom was rusted to the bottom track. So what we're gonna do here is we ended up breaking it free with the help of the forklift, my favorite tool. And now we're gonna run up the bolts to be able to take up the tension, to actually raise the door off the floor. Then we're gonna cut that rusty piece off the bottom so the door's actually floating like it should have. Watch your fingers. Pull. It spun. And now the door moves. When was the last time you think that door moved?
Well, this place was built 1920, so 1921.
Right, exactly.
Look at that. Look what you guys did. That's unbelievable, job, man.
First and foremost, the sign. You're still Zurba Industries. You're on the beach, getting a little zen. I'm just playing with a little bit of the angle of it. So we had Zany Graphics put together that sign for you.
We got a little zen. You know, it's just a little flavor.
Let's go around. Wow. I'll show you the front.
This is your new entrance.
Look at this.
Unreal.
Now, we'll show you the new.
Right on.
No way! Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
This is what a real shop looks like?
This is a night and day transformation, and to walk in there and see the lifts.
First things that we had to do for sure was the floors. We were able to get them done. So now these are clean. You spill something, you can get it up.
You had to move 5 cars in order to get 1 car out last time. Yeah. That doesn't work for us.
Now you've got everything worked out to where you've got a quick lift in and out. You've got a little bit longer term project. You've got your long term projects. And you can still move through here and even have cars here in the center if it's like a day job.
Easy to get cars in and out, especially these low cars.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to drive over any kind of speed bumps, nothing. All the cables are above you.
Your compressor's right over there. It's actually on right now. You don't hear it.
Wow.
And that's gonna power your new air tools. I mean, everything in this shop is now air, from your wrenches to your body saw. It's all done by air. You've got all your floor jacks, all your engine stands, your transmission stands. But the most important thing that you guys didn't have was wheel and tire equipment. The tire changing machine and wheel balancer will make you anywhere from $25 to $75 a wheel, and that is a massive profit center.
The other thing you see is where we're standing, we had this big pile of nonsense. Well, now you got lev rack. This is over 36 linear feet of shelving. It quadruples the amount of tools and parts you can store in this space, and now you'll be able to find them.
And they were able to get us some toolboxes full of tools, and it's all in there.
Oh, you're kidding me. No way.
What? Are you joking?
What's happened is that the value of the shop, it changed the thinking. Why am I struggling to do these other goals when if I was going full torque at the shop? Because that's the bread and butter and the bacon all in one mix.
One of the things you didn't have with fabricating that I didn't see that was in good shape was welders, so we brought in some tools.
Wow.
You got a TIG welder, MIG welder. You got plugs all over the shop.
So what you didn't have, well, you sort of did, but it rolled and used gasoline, was an office. They put in some furniture in your office and a little bit in the break room and in the entrance for customers. We set that up with a company. You can run tickets. You know exactly what you need to do to it. Every time you bill something, it has a job ticket number, and boom, you're able to calculate your profit.
The difference between the old shop and the new shop is like working in a hospital and you used to work at the county dump.
To me, professionalism is professionalism. We've got uniforms for everyone. That's got the new logo on there.
I've got these goals and these dreams and these big ambitions. And I know I'll produce them. I know I'll get there. It's gonna take us time to prove it, but we're gonna prove it.